What's up, YouTube? I'm Cody, I'm a third year medical student, and welcome back to my channel. Now, as you can see, I have on some UKNMD merch, which means I will be dropping a website pretty soon. It's gonna have a bunch of pre-med resources for you guys, as well as a shop so you can go and get some merch if you please. If you want quicker updates on when the website will be launching, you can follow my Instagram below. That way you can stay in tune. So with this vlog, I just want to shed some light on SGU, or the truth about SGU, so to speak, because a lot of people have been asking me really specific questions, so I thought I would just answer them here. But before I get started, a little bit of background on myself. I graduated in pre-med biology from Louisiana Tech University, and then I got my master's at Louisiana Tech in molecular science and nanotechnology. So when I was applying for med school, I applied to a few schools, about 10 schools, and for the majority of the schools, I was either waitlisted or bridged, which means they wanted me to go and get a master's, which would take another year or two. And then given that I maintained a certain GPA, I'd be matriculated into the medical program. But with SGU, I was accepted immediately. So I thought, why wait? I can go ahead and get my MD now. So I went with SGU. It was really nothing more, nothing less to it than that. I had a pretty high GPA. My MCAT score was a little iffy, so that's probably why I got waitlisted to those schools. But hey, I'm a third year now, so that's all that matters. So as far as SGU, the truth about SGU, let's see. So I guess I can start by saying that there's this kind of, a saying that goes around that U.S. schools are harder to get into, but easier to get out, and Caribbean schools are easier to get into and harder to get out. Now, I'm not throwing any shade on anybody's school, nothing like that. I'm just telling you the same. And I talked to a few of my U.S. colleagues, as well as some of the people that I go to school with, and they pretty much agree on the subject. So with SGU, so it's a private school, right? So that means it's a for-profit school. And so you pay this large amount of money. I think I just had to take out like $50,000 for one semester. So you pay a lot of money to go to this school, just because it's private and it's for-profit. And what SGU prides themselves on is, if you ever go to their website, it's gonna have that 95 or 96% USMLE Step 1 pass rate. It's gonna have that 800 to 900 residencies match each year, which is all true information. But in order to maintain those numbers and maintain that appeal, the marketing scheme, I guess you would call it, they make the coursework a lot harder just to kind of weed people out. I don't wanna make it seem like it's a bad thing, but they do make the curriculum very, very challenging. And so if you're coming to SGU thinking that, hey, I got into this school, it's gonna be a breeze, no, that's definitely not the case. They're gonna challenge you, they're gonna ask you a bunch of questions that really aren't as high yield as some of the schools, like the US schools will teach you a bunch of high yield stuff. With SGU, they'll get down to the nitty gritty, just to make sure that you're paying attention to all these things. And so that they can test you on them. But with that being said, they do provide you with a bunch of resources that you need in order to sort of get over that hump. So they provide you with tutoring services. You can do one-on-one tutoring sessions. There's something called DES, where if I'm learning about, let's say, lysosomal storage diseases, right? And I have a bunch of other classes like histology and cell biology or whatever, and I want to focus on biochem because I'm having a hard time going through that. I can sign up for a lysosomal storage disease DES session, which is a group of about 10 to 12 students, as well as a upper term student who probably got, I think, an A or something in the class, and they kind of zone in and tone into that particular subject. And you can pretty much do that for any subject that you're taking and you're having problems with. And then you can also talk to DES about just making a schedule for yourself. And there's also something called the ITI program. So if you need a little bit of extra help, they'll give it to you. I think it's some smaller group sessions that work for a lot of people, and a lot of people really enjoy it. But yeah, that's pretty much the truth about SGU. Am I missing something? I don't think so, but if I am, you can always ask me questions. Leave it down in the comment box. I will get back to you. I have a few more videos to catch up on, but this particular topic was one that a lot of people were asking about. So I hope that gave you a little bit of insight. Just remember that if you're planning to come to SGU, it's not going to be a walk in the park, okay? It's going to be challenging, but you can always overcome that challenge. And I think that SGU does a good job of preparing you for your step. I scored pretty decent on my step one, and so I felt really prepared when I took the exam. But yeah, that's pretty much it. This is not a shame video, and this is not a promotional video. Neither one. It's just my opinion and some of the things that I've noticed, and I've talked to some of my colleagues about, and they've noticed it too. So I just wanted to share some light on that. Again, not a shame video, and it's not a promotional video. So I just want you to have as much information as you possibly can, without sugarcoating anything, because some people will sugarcoat stuff and give you a little bit of the facts, but I want to make sure I give you all the facts before you decide on the school that you want to go to. So like I said, if you have any questions, any comments, any content that you want uploaded, make sure you drop it down below in the comment box, and I'll be sure to get back to you. Shout out, you can have you.